Hi, good afternoon everyone. In the last class, we have discussed about P-N junction diode. P-N junction diode, where we have discussed about forward bias and reverse bias. In forward bias, P is connected to positive terminal and N is connected to negative terminal of the battery. Whereas in reverse bias, P is connected to negative terminal and N is connected to positive terminal of the battery. In both the cases, forward bias will have more current and reverse bias will have less current. In rectifiers, the reverse bias current is going to be taken as minimum and even we can't consider it. So, rectifier and its types. Today's topic is rectifiers and its types. Rectifier is a device which is an application of P-N junction diode. Rectifier works. A rectifier is an application of a P-N junction diode. So what is rectifier means? So rectifier is a device which converts alternating current into direct current. Alternating current into direct current. Alternating. The word clearly indicates alternating means changing. From time to time, the current changes. Direct current means there will be no change in a direction. Its direction will be along only in single direction. There will be no change in phase. The current will move only in one direction. Such a current is called direct current. So in such a way, rectifier is a device which converts alternating current into direct current. And such a process of converting all AC into DC is called as rectification. For this, the devices used are going to be called as rectifiers. So, converting AC into DC is called rectification, and the devices used for this purpose are called as rectifiers. These rectifiers are of mainly two types. The first one is half wave rectifier and the second one is full wave rectifier. So rectifiers are classified into two types, half wave and full wave. So in such a way, in one word, process of converting AC into DC, alternating current into direct current, is called rectification, and the device used for this purpose are called rectifiers. These rectifiers are of two types. First one is half wave rectifier, second one is full wave rectifier. So we will discuss each one briefly now. Before going to tell these two points, or before going to discuss about half wave and full wave rectifier, you should note forward bias and reverse bias once again. In case of forward bias, P-type semiconductor is connected to positive terminal and N-type semiconductor is connected to negative terminal. Then only current flows. In case of reverse bias, P is connected to negative terminal of the battery and N is connected to positive terminal of the battery. Here current flows but is minimum. For ideal cases, we can't consider reverse bias. So, in case of rectifiers, only when the diode is in forward bias, then only the flow of current takes place. So, we will discuss half wave and full wave rectifiers now. So the first rectifier, what we are going to call it as half wave rectifier. Half wave rectifier. So just look at the circuit. So for this circuit, what you have to require is, the first part is transformer. Second part is AC source. Third part is PN junction diode. And the fourth part you have to require is low resistance, which is indicated by RL. So these are the four parts which we require for a half wave rectifier. Transformer. Transformer is used for voltage changes. Why? We have to convert AC into DC. AC is taken as input and DC is taken as output. So AC input should be converted into DC output. For that sake, we are going to use a device called as transformer. Transformer generally contains two coils. First one is primary coil and the second one is secondary coil. Second part is AC source. Why we have to require an AC source, which is going to convert into DC source. Third part is PN junction diode. Already we discussed PN junction diode and what is forward bias and what is reverse bias. And the last part is load resistance indicated by RL. R is resistance and suffix L indicates load. So what is the use of load resistance means? Between ends of load resistance, between the ends of load resistance, we are going to calculate output voltage or DC output. AC is acting as input, so DC is going to be treated as output. So between the ends of the load resistance, we are going to calculate DC output. So the circuit mainly contains four parts. The first one is transformer, which contains two coils, coil P and coil S. Coil P means primary coil, coil S means secondary coil. Second one is AC source, which should be converted into DC. Third part is PN junction diode, which acts as forward bias as well as reverse bias. And the last part is load resistance indicated by RL. Where R is called resistance and L is called load. So RL is going to be considered as load resistance. Between the ends of load resistance, we are going to calculate the DC output. Now coming to the circuit. If you look at the circuit of half wave rectifier, the first part is transformer. Transformer contains two coils. So this is the transformer indicated by this, which contains two coils. So this is the primary coil. One more coil which we are going to take it as secondary coil. So this is the part we are going to call transformer. Having two coils, primary coil and secondary coil, yes. Second part is AC source. This primary coil is connected to a AC source. This is going to be called as AC source. AC, alternating current source, which should be converted into DC. So, the circuit consists of a transformer having two coils, P, primary coil, and S, as secondary coil. This primary coil is connected to a AC source. To the secondary coil, we are going to connect a diode. This is PN junction diode. To this diode, you are going to connect a load resistance indicated by RL. Load resistance or L. And we discuss between the ends of load resistance, we are going to calculate output voltage. So between the ends of load resistance, you are going to calculate output or DC output. This is AC source or AC input from which we are going to convert into DC output. So this is the complete diagram of the half wave rectifier. Here the ends of secondary coil are taken as A and B. So this indicates the diagram of the half wave rectifier. So once again, looking at this circuit, the circuit consists of A. Transformer. Transformer contains two coils, P and S. P is called primary coil, S is called secondary coil. This primary coil is connected to a AC input or AC source. The secondary coil is connected to a diode, which is connected to a load resistance. Between the ends of load resistance, output voltage or DC output is going to be measured or calculated. Ends of the secondary coil are going to be taken as A and B. So this is the complete construction of the circuit which we are going to use in half wave rectifier. Now coming to its working, how this half wave rectifier works. So the working of half-wave rectifier contains two cycles. It contains two cycles. First one is called positive half cycle. Second one is called negative half cycle. First one is called positive half cycle. Second one is called negative half cycle. From these two cycles, we can explain the working of a half-wave rectifier. So, in positive half cycle, this A, the end A becomes positive and this end B becomes negative. In case of positive half cycle, A is positive and B becomes negative. If A is positive, this is PN junction diode. This is P and this is N. If A is positive, if the positive is connected to P end, then the diode is in a forward bias. We discussed it. If P type is connected to positive terminal, diode is in a forward bias. So, in case of positive half cycle, A is positive, B is negative. So, A being positive connected to P side, the diode is in forward bias. So in case of positive half cycle, diode is in forward bias. If the diode is in forward bias, current flows. If current flows, we will get DC output between the ends of load resistance. We can get the DC output between the ends of load resistance. In case of negative half cycle, this A becomes negative and this B becomes positive. A becomes negative and B becomes positive. If A becomes negative, negative is connected to P. So, the diode will be in a reverse bias. Negative end is connected to P terminal means the diode will be in a reverse bias. So, if the diode is in reverse bias, there will be no flow of current. Even though it flows, it is very negligible and we discuss it. For ideal diodes or for ideal rectifiers, we can't consider the reverse bias current. So for that sake, we are going to take the current as zero. So in case of negative half cycle, A is negative, B is positive. So the negative term or the end is connected to P. So the diode will be in reverse bias. If the diode is in reverse bias, there will be no current flow. If there is no current flow, the DC output is nothing. There will be no DC output. So here no current flows, so there will be no DC output. In case of positive half cycle, A is positive, B is negative. So the diode is in forward bias, so current flows, and some DC output is calculated between the ends of your resistance. In case of negative half cycle, being A negative and B positive, this A becomes negative and this B becomes positive. As it is negative, which is connected to P terminal, diode will be in reverse bias, so no current flows. If there is no current, we are going to get zero DC output. In such a way, the half-wave rectifier works. Coming to its important graphical points, just we can discuss how the graph looks like. So, we are going to draw the graphs. Taking time along x-axis, the y-axis indicates voltage. Voltage across A at point A. This indicates voltage across your resistance. Voltage across your resistance. So in the graph, time is taken along x-axis and voltage is drawn along y-axis. This indicates AC input and this indicates DC output. Why? Rectifier is the device used to convert AC into DC. So AC is input and DC is output. So in case of AC input, voltage across A. In case of DC output, voltage across load resistance. First, in positive half cycle, A is positive. If A is positive, the diode is in forward bias. In negative half cycle, A is negative, so the diode is in reverse bias. So we have to change the direction in such a way. Positive half cycle, negative half cycle. Once again, positive half cycle. In such a way, we are going to get a wave for AC input. Coming to DC output, this is positive half cycle. If the diode is in positive half cycle, diode is in forward bias, so current flows. So we will get an output. So we will get output. This is positive half cycle, this is negative half cycle. In negative half cycle, the diode is in reverse bias. If the diode is in reverse bias, there will be no current. So you should not show anything in the graph. This place is completely vacant. Once again, positive half cycle, negative half cycle, positive half cycle. In positive half cycle, the diode is in forward bias. If there is diode is in forward bias, we will get some voltage. So you have to indicate the graph like this. In such a way, the AC input will be in form of a wave. The DC output will be in form of pulses. We are going to call this word as pulses. These pulses are not continuous. First one continuous, next there is a gap. Next one, and then again a gap. So these are which type of pulses means? These are discontinuous pulses. The output is in form of discontinuous pulses. So once again, if you look at the graph, there are two half cycles, positive half cycle, negative half cycle, positive and then negative. In case of positive half cycle, diode is in forward bias, so current flows. So we will show output. In case of reverse bias, in case of negative half cycle, diode is in reverse bias, so no current flows. So you have to just leave a gap. Once again, the diode is in forward bias, so you have to show a output. So the input is in form of a wave, the output is in form of pulses but having some gaps. So this output is going to be called as discontinuous pulses. In such a way, we are going to show AC input in form of a wave and DC output in form of discontinuous pulses. And the last to discuss in half wave rectifier is nothing but efficiency. Indicated by eta. Efficiency indicated by eta. So efficiency means the ratio between DC output power to AC input power. DC is output, AC is input. So the ratios between DC and AC powers is going to be called as efficiency. Perfect definition is the ratio between DC output power to AC input power, whose formula is given by 0.406 into RL by RF plus RL into 100. This is the exact formula for efficiency of half wave rectifier. Looking at the formula, 0.406 into RL. RL indicates low resistance. By RF plus RL. RF, F means forward. R means resistance. Forward resistance. As current flows only in forward bias, we are going to take only forward resistance into consideration, which is indicated by small r suffix F, RF, which is going to be called forward resistance. It should be multiplied with 100 so that you will get efficiency in terms of percentage. Now coming to the definition of half wave rectifier. Half wave rectifier is the rectifier which rectifies only one half cycle. Only one half cycle. Why? There are two half cycles, positive half cycle, negative half cycle. In case of positive half cycle, only current flows. So it rectifies only one half cycle. And one more definition is, if you multiply 0.406 into 100, which gives 40.6%. 0.406 into 100, which gives 40.6%. So 40.6% of AC is converted into DC, which is going to be called half wave rectifier. So in one word, rectification is the process converting AC into DC, and the device used for this purpose is called rectifier. Rectifiers are of two types, half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier. In case of half wave rectifier, there are two half cycles, positive half cycle, negative half cycle. In positive half cycle, A is positive, B is negative. If A is positive, diode will be in forward bias, so current flows. In case of negative half cycle, A is negative, B is positive. If A is negative, diode is in reverse bias, so no current flows. Out of positive half cycle and negative half cycle, only positive half cycle will have current flow. Hence, it is called half wave rectifier. Only one half cycle rectifies. Only one half cycle allows the flow of current. Coming to the formula for efficiency, ratio between DC output power to AC input power, whose formula is 0.406 RL by RF plus RL into 100. If you multiply 0.406 into 100, which gives 40.6%. So 40.6% of AC converts into DC. So in such a way, in case of half wave rectifier which contains only one diode and out of two half cycles, positive half cycle and negative half cycle, only positive half cycle is responsible for the flow of current and rectifies 40.6% of AC into DC. In such a way, the half wave rectifier working can be explained. So, just now we discussed half wave rectifier. In case of half wave rectifier, we used a transformer having a primary coil P, secondary coil S, only one diode, and we have used a load resistance RL along with an AC source. In case of full wave rectifier, the same things which we have used in half wave rectifier are again repeated. Along with them, we have to take one more diode. So, the requirements of full wave rectifier are, first of all, we have to take a transformer having a primary coil and a secondary coil. And there, in half wave rectifier, we have used only one diode. But in case of full wave rectifier, we have to use two PN junction diodes. There we have to use only one diode. Here we are going to use two diodes, which are going to be taken as D1 and D2. And then we are going to use a AC source, which is also called as AC input. And finally, we are going to take a load resistance indicated by RL. Between the ends of the load resistance, we are going to calculate output voltage. So here, we are going to take two PN junction diodes, which are indicated by D1 and D2. A transformer having primary coil P, secondary coil S, and then a load resistance RL. Between the ends of load resistance, we are going to calculate output voltage or output DC, and then we are going to use an AC source which can also be called as AC input. Now, coming to the circuit of a full wave rectifier, the same diagram which we have drawn, but a small change. First of all, we are going to take a transformer having a primary coil P, which is connected to a AC source. This is AC source, which can also be called AC input. So, the transformer which contains two coils, primary coil P and secondary coil S. Primary coil is connected to a AC input. And secondary coil S, whose ends are taken as A and B. In the last diagram, this end A is connected to a diode D. Here, we are going to take two diodes, which are going to be called as D1 and D2. So, ends of the secondary coil S are connected to two diodes. These two NNs, this is PN, this is NN, these two NNs are connected. Now, just like the last case of half wave rectifier, if you place low resistance here, if this is in forward bias, it will be in reverse bias. So current flows, as it is in reverse bias, no current flows. So for that sake, load resistance should not be connected here. It should be connected in a different way. How we are going to connect it is from the center of the secondary coil This is the connection which we are going to connect load resistance. From the center of the secondary coil, you should give the connection in such a way. If you give the connection like this, it is connected to this end or this end. Suppose if you give the connection like this, these two wires will never cross each other. Those two are completely different wires. So for that sake, we use the connection in such a way. So from the center of the secondary coil, the load resistance RL is connected. As the center of the secondary coil is connected to earth, it is earth, it means given connection to earth. This type of transformer whose center is tapped, this transformer is called as center tapped transformer. Center trapped transformer. So this is the complete circuit of the full wave rectifier. So the full wave rectifier consists of a transformer having primary coil P, secondary coil S. The primary coil is connected to a AC input. A comma B are the ends of secondary coil. The ends of the secondary coil are connected to two diodes whose other ends are connected to each other. From the center of the secondary coil, which is earth connected, is connected to load resistance. Between the ends of the load resistance, we are going to calculate DC output. It is AC input, and this is DC output. By rectifier is the device which converts AC input into DC output, AC to DC. So this is the diagram which we are going to take. Now, coming to its working. The same pattern which we followed in the last case. So there will be two half cycles. One is positive half cycle, second one is negative half cycle. So first one is positive half cycle, second one is negative half cycle. In case of positive half cycle, this NA is positive, this end B is negative. This end A is positive, end B is negative. If A is positive, positive to P is called as forward bias. If it is in forward bias, current flows. So through diode D1, current flows. B is negative. If B is negative, whose end is connected to positive P? If P is connected to negative, this diode is in reverse bias. If this is in reverse bias, no current flows. So in case of positive half cycle, A is positive, B is negative. As A is positive, diode D1 is in forward bias. If it is in forward bias, some output is going to be measured. But B is negative, so diode D2 is in reverse bias. If it is in reverse bias, no current flows. So in positive half cycle, due to diode D1, which is in forward bias, current flows. Diode D2 is in reverse bias, so no current flows. So in case of positive half cycle, due to diode D1, current flows in the circuit. In case of negative half cycle, A is negative and B is positive. So A becomes negative and B becomes positive. If A is negative, then this diode will be in reverse bias. Negative to P, which is in reverse bias. If this is in reverse bias, no current flows. Here B is connected, which is positive. So positive to P. So diode D2 will be in a forward bias. If diode D2 is in forward bias, current flows through the circuit and you can get an output only due to diode D2. So in case of negative half cycle, diode D1 is in reverse bias, so no current flows. Diode D2, which is connected to positive, is in forward bias, So current flows. In case of positive half cycle, current flows due to diode D1. In case of negative half cycle, current flows due to diode D2. So once again, coming to its working. So in order to explain the working, there are two half cycles. Positive half cycle, negative half cycle. In positive half cycle, A is positive, B is negative. If A is positive, diode will be in forward bias. If it is in forward bias, current flows. B is negative, so diode D2 is in reverse bias, so no current flows. In case of negative half cycle, A is negative and B becomes positive. If A is negative, diode D1 is in reverse bias. And B is positive, diode D2 is in forward bias. As D2 is in forward bias, current flows. So you will get an output voltage or output only due to diode D2 as it is in forward bias. So here, the main difference between half wave and full wave diagram is, in half wave rectifier, you use only one diode. In full wave rectifiers, we have used two diodes, D1 and D2. In half wave rectifier, only in positive half cycle, current flows. In negative half cycle, no current flows. But here, in positive half cycle, current flows due to diode D1. In negative half cycle, current flows due to diode D2. So, both half cycles, positive half cycle, negative half cycle, are responsible for the flow of current. Hence, this device is called as full wave rectifier, half plus half, as both half cycles are responsible for the flow of current. So it is called as full wave rectifier. There it rectifies only one half cycle, so it is called half wave rectifier. But here it rectifies both. Both half cycles are responsible for the flow of current, so we are going to call it as full wave rectifier. Now coming to its graphical forms. So here we have two diodes. So diagram would be, on x-axis, you have to take time. On y-axis, you have to take voltage. In case of a half-wave rectifier, there is only one diode. But in case of full-wave rectifiers, there are two diodes. So you have to take two graphs for AC input. So this indicates voltage at A. This indicates voltage at B. This indicates voltage at load resistance RL. Voltage at A, voltage at B, voltage at load resistance. These two graphs use AC input. This one gives DC output. So the voltage at A with respect to time, voltage at B with respect to time, as we are going to use two diodes. As both diodes are responsible for the flow of current, we are going to take both the graphs for AC input. And finally, voltage at load resistance, which gives DC output. Now, first of all, positive half cycle. In positive half cycle, A is positive. If A is positive, diode D1 is in forward bias. So, at A, being positive, it is in forward bias. If at A, being forward bias, at B, which is negative, diode D2 is in reverse bias. So, we have to indicate the graph in such a way. So, at A, which is positive, diode will be in forward bias. B, which is negative for positive half cycle, D2 is in reverse bias. So current flows due to diode D1. So you are going to get an output voltage due to D1. So the output voltage is due to D1 in case of positive half cycle. In case of negative half cycle, A is negative means diode is in reverse bias. So graph would be in such a way. If the graph, if at A being negative, it is in reverse bias. If A is negative, B is positive. If B is positive, the diode is in forward bias. So you have to indicate the graph. If A is negative, diode D1 is in reverse bias, so no current flows. If B is positive, diode D2 is in forward bias and so current flows. So you will get an output voltage due to D2. In such a way, by moving the cycles from positive half cycle to negative half cycle to positive half cycle to negative half cycle, you will get the DC output in terms of pulses which are continuous. In the last case, in case of half wave rectifier, positive half cycle leads current, negative half cycle does not lead current, then positive. So there is a gap. So we call it as discontinuous pulses. But here there is no gap. So the output is going to be called continuous pulses. And the inputs are in form of waves. So AC input is in form of wave. DC output is in form of pulses which are continuous. So once again, to indicate the graph, we are going to take time along x-axis and voltages along y-axis. Here there are two half cycles, positive half cycle, negative half cycle. In positive half cycle, A is positive. If A is positive, diode will be in forward bias. If A is positive, B is negative, so the diode D2 will be in reverse bias. If it is in reverse bias, no current flows. So current flows only due to diode D1. So due to diode D1 only, you are going to get an output voltage or DC output. In case of negative half cycle, A is negative. If A is negative, D1 will be in reverse bias. If A is negative, B is positive. If B is positive, diode D2 is in forward bias. So D2 will be in such a way. So as it is in forward bias, it leads to current. So voltage will be due to diode D2 in such a way. The AC input is in form of waves. DC output is in form of pulses which are continuous. Such a way we can explain how current flow or AC input or DC output in case of full wave rectifier. In case of half wave rectifier, output DC is in form of discontinuous pulses, whereas here it is in form of continuous pulses. So lastly, we will discuss the concept of efficiency. Already we discussed the efficiency definition. Eta is equal to ratio between DC output power to AC input power. The ratio between output DC power to input AC power is called efficiency. In case of half wave rectifier, we have taken 0.406. In case of full wave, having only diodes, two diodes, both diodes in two different cases are responsible for the flow of current. So 0.406 into 2, which gives 0.812. So the formula becomes 0.812 RL by RF plus RL into 100, where RL indicates load resistance, RF indicates forward resistance. In case of half-wave rectifier, efficiency is 40.6%. In case of full-wave rectifier, then 0.812 multiplied with 100 will give 81.2%. So, efficiency of full-wave rectifier is 81.2%. Already we discussed. Definition for half-wave rectifier, which rectifies only one half cycle. Full-wave rectifier, which rectifies two half cycles. There, 40.6% of AC converted into DC. But in case of full-wave rectifier, the efficiency is 81.2%. Means 81.2% of AC is converted into DC. In such a way, we are going to show how half-wave and full-wave acts as applications for PN junction diode and are responsible for converting AC into DC.